crappy winter weather and sicknesses and all that sort of garbage. Just at the usual place again. I'm going to try a couple of spots that we haven't really dug much. Might be lucky. Danny again. Yeah, so hopefully you haven't all left us, because it's been, seems to be months since we've actually put up a video, but that's life, I suppose. Anyway, we'll bring you in soon. The first real find here is a, I don't know what it is, it's, I thought it was a sort of modern-ish junk, just because of the look of it, it looks quite new, but it says patent April 23rd, 1878, patent October 21st, 1884, so potentially old. It says winding on it, it's got a sort of stylized arrow, which is kind of cool. Don't know what it's off at the moment, but with those numbers it should be easy enough to find, so that's cool. Alright, we'll keep on. Nothing amazing here, but kind of interesting. I think it's an old pocket knife, or it used to be anyway. There's not much left of it now, just the brass end. Yeah, not much else otherwise. Danny's just headed over to another place that we haven't really tried much yet. There's an old fruit tree there, which is always a good sign. So Danny's just hooked up something here. That's pretty cool. Did you hack it, did you?
No.
Oh, that's cracked. Yeah. What do you reckon it's made of?
It's pretty heavy. It's
like lead, maybe.
Yeah.
Weird. No writing or anything, eh?
No. I thought it was a squashed lamp base when I first pulled it out, but obviously it's not.
Maybe. Hmm. Very odd. Right, nice one. I got something here. I don't know what it is. Might as well do it in the same video. These live digs are always good. Probably be a roofing nail or something. Oh no, there we go. Some sort of very fine buckle. It's got a bit of gilding on it, actually.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It's like a suspender thingy.
Yeah, it does. Could be another bit in there, maybe. I'll dig it out anyway. Yeah, there you go. I'm not sure what we've got here yet, but I see the gleam of gold. Danny's pissed.
Yep. Jewel- I'm gonna find jewelry.
Jewelry was her goal for today. All I wanted was a gold nugget. So, let's have a look here. This be, I don't know if it's real gold, but
it's promising. The
first gold ring I've ever found, if so. Oh, what is this? It's funny looking, it's crushed, whatever it is. It certainly looks gold though, doesn't it? Yeah, it's definitely gold. It's a shame it's crushed like that. It looks like it would have had a stone in it. It's like, yeah, a triangular.
Would have had a big square stone, obviously.
It's pretty crude. It looks like it's been resized as well. Still, I don't know. Yeah, it's pretty weighty for the size of it. Check that out. Gold ring. Yeah. Hmm.
I like. Yeah, it's got hallmarks in it.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, heaps of them.
Oh, sweet.
Hey, Mr. Powers! I love gold! The look of it, the taste of it, the smell of it, the texture!
You'd probably even get it restored.
Maybe.
The jeweler would be a... Oh, it's pretty soft, like it's... True. Tends not to fatigue, so you could get it opened up. I suppose it should have a good look in case the stone's in there.
That's
if.
Pretty awesome.
That's what it had. We'll check that out. Find of the day. Yes. All right, we'll bring you back in if we get something else. I guess it's too much to expect that I'll find gold rings all day, every day, you know? It's back to the old favorites. Bent harmonica reed. Score. Anyway, we're going to... it's probably hard to pick on this camera, but we'll try around this old home site. There's a chimney in the middle there and these trees, and yeah, visit pretty much a couple of similar sites on the way back. They're places we've been to before, but the ground's particularly good today. We've had quite a bit of rain, so it's nice and damp and soft. So we'll see how we go. We'll do this one live. No idea really what it is, but it's a sweet signal, so we'll see what we got. It was a 14:30. So dunno. It's a bit hard to see. Got long shadows today. There we go, some kind of a latch. Actually found one exactly the same as this before. And I'm not sure what it's off. Brass. It's just a funny shape. It's hard to see what it would have been used for. Yeah. New furniture probably, something like that. Don't know. Another good signal here. Strange numbering, but ...420. Just a little bit odd. You can see how black the soil is here. It's obviously been some burning or something going on. Ah, good one. It's a lead washer. Yep. Alright, I've got high hopes for this one. Nice signal. 9:35. It's a bit iffy actually. Jumping, it's a solid sort of signal on the trace, but odd numbers. There's a lot of iron in the ground here too, so I found that sometimes the numbering isn't that consistent. You can see all the worms in here, it's crazy. And there's a nail, it's not the target, might be like so dodgy though. Haha, look at that, it's a penny, I think. Yep, Britannia. Nice. It's got some gunk on it, but these come out really nicely. Yeah, that's in great nick, that one. It's Edward, so it's a little bit later. Excuse me for a sec. 1908, maybe. It's always the last number that's hard to read. But anyway, there you go. You can see the condition on it. It's going to have a great patina. One penny. What a beauty. You can see how good this detector is with these sort of targets as well. Massive nail. And it still managed to pick that coin, so that's really good. Nice. Let's keep going. It's proof you can never hunt a spot out. Danny's just got a half penny. Britannia, is it?
Yep.
Sweet.
1891.
Oh, nice. Old one. Cool. It's
a bit bent.
It is, isn't it? Awesome. Like most of them, though, you can still got good detail on it. Very good. First coin for the day. Now you just need a gold ring.
Yeah, shut up.
Just about to have some food and I got a 12:36, a nice red spot, which is always a good sign. Let's have a look. Seems very shallow, but it can be deceiving sometimes. a big worm. Yeah, it's a Paris buckle, or a bit of a one. Damn, I was hoping for a coin. That's all right though. So first dig after our little food break's a nice button. It's looks to be a navy type theme again. Danny's just found this thing, which explains what that piece I found was. Yeah, I had this, maybe it's the reverse side of it, it's curved. Curved brass. It's patent, what did you say, it says patent? Oh, it does too.
Patent number, I can't read the number.
Yeah, there you go. That's cool, it might let us know what it is.
It's a fair way away from where you found it.
Oh, I found a few of them before, just with that square shape. Yeah, it's strange. It does look to be a latch, but it's hard to see what it'd be off. Might be a bit of an old garden or something here. There's a heap of these trees around and got an old nozzle. It's a good one. Yeah, it's very similar to that other one we found, isn't it?
Yeah.
Shame it's all cracked.
Broken,
but yeah. It's a solid old thing. Bronze. There you go, we got gold, silver and bronze today. Bonus. Yeah, good one. I like most of this place. It's just habitation everywhere. I dug this harmonica reed, as you do. But yeah, crockery everywhere. Big pieces too. It's that thing. Glass. It's like a piece of a bottle or something. It's just never ending. It's a good sign. I've got to fulfill my daily quota of these things. Clock gear. It's the only one for today, actually. Oh no, I got that frame before. No gears in it though, so yeah, there you go. Now it's complete. Alright, on to some coins, hopefully. We're running out of time, I think. Probably got another hour or so. We'll see what we get. Dug a nice signal here, and it's a cool spoon. I think it could be silver. Possibly. It's, might be plated. It's just in better nick than most of them. So, it's interesting. It's a funny shape. Like a baby spoon or something. Got some hallmarks there, so I'll be able to get some detail off that. And another mystery type item. It's almost like a, I thought it was a ring pull at first, but it's like a cool old bottle opener or something. You know, that probably wouldn't really work, but yeah, it's strange. Well made, it's brass. Looks like it would have been probably electroplated or something. Interesting. I'm on a cutlery roll at the moment. Just seeing this sticking out, it's a, looks like a massive thing. Oh. Would have been a spoon. It's got some good markings on it actually. More than you usually see. Just plated again, but yep, the end of it's nowhere to be seen, but never mind. Be able to get an age off that probably. It's a solid thing. Good one. Well, I dug another target maybe a foot away from that spoon end, and here's the head off it, so got the whole thing after all. This is potentially decent. It's a 1241. I'd like to say it's a coin, but this area hasn't brought up any yet. Oh, it's grass. Soil's great, but it's got this kikuyu or something all over it. Just these little tendrils. Cross fingers. Oh, check that out. I think it's a watchback. Nice. Pattern on that's great. Very delicate. But it looks like it would have been maybe gilt. I can see some gold around this edge. But yeah, you can see the hinge on this side. Very cool. I'll have a check in here. There might be the other side of it. Probably overly optimistic, but yeah, nowhere to be seen. Strange how it goes like that. You've got to wonder what happened to the rest of it. Still, that's very cool. Nice relic. Solid chunk of something here. Don't know what it is. It almost looks like a stirrupine, but it's pretty tiny. I don't know what sort of foot you'd get through there. Probably off a wagon or buggy or something like that. It's had a lot of wear here, obviously, so it's been tied onto something. Yeah, interesting. Give me your thoughts if you like. Danny reckons she's found a whole bottle over there. Digging to China to find out. I've got a pocket knife, I reckon. It's all splayed open and ruined, but that's not surprising. In fact, it could be a harmonica, maybe. Dunno, I'll have to give that a clean. I'll chuck it in the electrolysis and see how it comes up. It seems to have a bit of a pattern on it, but I can't make anything out. Definitely old. Nice. The archaeology paid off. Whole green bottle. That's the first one we found here, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the first whole one. It's not even chipped.
It's awesome. Check that thing out. Yeah, that's cool. They're a nice shape. I don't think I've ever seen a whole one before. They're always broken. Well done.
Made a big mess.
No, it should clean up nicely. I wonder about all these scratches. There must be some way to get them off. I think I've seen people tumbling them with like a polishing grit. I don't know. If any of you bottle gurus know how to remove these scratches off them, give us a shout. Nice. Well done. Danny thought she had a half penny over there, but it's not. Is it like a badge or something? I've just dug a nice, these big Martini Henry cartridges, complete for change. Good condition, actually.
I don't know, it's got stuff written around. I just saw that.
Oh, it's a big flat button, I reckon. Yeah, it's got a bit of a design, eh? Oh, it is writing.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's a button, I think. That's cool. Nice. We just had a visit from the landowner as well, who put us on to another landowner out here who actually offered, said we could go on to her place to look at an old butchery, butcher's shop presumably, and four houses he reckons. So yeah, that's next weekend, that'll be good. So we're about to head anyway, we might get a few more digs in, but if we don't see it, we'll hopefully be back next weekend and check out this joint. Take it easy.